So in this video, this is going to be contre jour and trying to get the feeling of strong light. I'm in Manarola, I think it's that, one of the Cinque Terre villages, and down by the coast, there's the sea. In fact, that's another possible painting subject, looking down towards the water there. But this is what I'm going to do. Boats up here, light hitting the tops of the boats, light hitting some of those buildings, well, maybe some figures also. Let's see how we get on. So as I go through this demo, the light will come across us, so please excuse a little bit of a lighter feeling to it. So we're going to be contre jour here, looking against the light, and first of all just deciding on the composition. So I'm going to start with the left hand side first of all. And then that sort of strategic boat. Very ornate front. That tarpaulin over the back. And there is a boat just here in front of me, so I'll try and get that one in as well. And then over to the right, there's a three or four boats pointing into the scene. That's actually quite nice from a composition point of view. I'll let it get in two of them. There's the that's the actual slope, that's the kind of angle of that slope, about that. We'll get in a few figures as well. Some figures just coming down into view. Maybe one here as well. Climbing up the hill. Now, these buildings behind me, or sorry, in the background, these buildings. To try and capture a few of those. Slope down to the right. Like that. More figures there. Good, that's about it. That's what I need for the drawing. Oh, this boat here, just make sure this is looking right. It's tarpaulin over there. Good. And here comes the sun. So we just tilt it down a bit. So we're getting a little bit of a sky over here. Tilt that back. And then a base colour for the buildings in the background, which is a sort of warm terracotta. We've got something here, a warm terracotta. Mixture of yellow ochres. Just something to cover up that area, right. Continue down this left-hand side, bit of yellow ochre, burnt sienna. We're going a little bit darker in there later on. Good, we'll just let that dry a bit. Right, buildings. Rising crimson, ultramarine blue, burnt sienna. Test. Right. You have to get the feeling of some of these roofs. And then that right hand side.
I don't know tonight.
Right hand side. Come back to that. Thank you. Whoops. Got to be careful here. Don't get too messy. As we come down, got more terraces. Right, as we come down to the bottom, it's going to get really dark. That's cutting up to the edge of the wall on the left. Down to a figure. Head. Two figures just on the other side of the boat. And now we're coming down to the other boats on the other side. Right, next. Let's do the wall on the left. Yellow ochre, neutral tint. Trying to get some idea of the perspective on that side as well. Right, boats, let's do this. This little bit of tarpaulin over the back. There. And then the actual boat itself is gonna be a sort of warmish colour. The tarpaulin at the back is quite cool. Get a good line here. Down to the back of this boat. and a shadow. We'll start off with a neutral tint, bit of cobalt blue. Just tilt that back a bit. And then, so cobalt blue, neutral tint. Not sure what's going on there. Here we are. Now, far boats. On the right hand side. Slither of light on the top of the boat. While that's drying, I will do the blue boat. Shadow. Coming off of that one. Back to the shadow underneath the fire boats. Thank you. Okay, figures. Do some fresh colour first. Start with the left hand one. Two. And this one is walking up the hill. Give this figure light clothing. And then this one on the right hand side. Bit of shadow. Right, details. First of all, a little bit of darker shadow underneath the rocks there. Maybe a little bit of shadow behind some of the boulders on this side. Blue stripy stuff, quite distinctive in this area. A bit of detail to that bit there. Just a few little lines. Just to help define the gradient a little bit. Right, windows, lots of dark windows. Let's get a little flat brush for this. Strategic windows here and there. Hello there. And now, some darker lines on the buildings, just to define, make the edge of the roofs just a bit stronger. Right, I think it's about done.
As I normally do, just a quick review at the end of the demo, just to give myself a little bit of a critique. Manarola then, on the Cinque, Terre. This is where I was actually painting from. This is the hilltop village here and the road leading down to the sea. There's a little sort of slipway here going down to the water's edge. I was actually right there. And let me just take you to a photo I took of the area. This is where I was painting from. Initially in the shade, but as you saw in the video, the sun came around. So it was a little bit of a battle with the sunlight coming towards me and then the heat. You could actually see the haze of the heat rising from my painting board. So apologies if you saw a little bit of some waviness of the video. That was the heat coming towards me. And, well, of course, being plein air in a very popular place like Manarola, the Cinque Terre, lots of people out and about, and so apologies for the background noise, but a contre jour scene looking up to the houses up on the hillside, the boats in the middle ground, foreground boat, contre jour, which is really, really works really well with watercolor. You've got these silhouetted shapes, you have lots of lights and darks contrasting with each other. Obviously works well in other mediums, photography, but especially well with watercolor. And yeah, nice scene. Actually, just on the left there, this metal reel, that's where my camera was attached to there. I had my camera attached here on a sort of boom arm, and my camera was there pointing down to my board. That's and you might have seen it shaking just a little bit as I was, might have been just rocking or knocking accidentally that reel on the left. Anyway, my finished painting, which on the whole I'm fairly pleased with, captured the essence of the scene. The light hitting the rooftops in the background, a few figures milling around, connecting with different shapes, giving a sense of scale and a little bit of extra interest. The shadows as well, the lights and the darks. The framing of the scene on the left-hand side with that retaining wall, where there was a walkway above me, and that's probably where you heard most of the people from. Might have gone a little bit too dark with the little gaps in the rocks there. So I could have maybe gone a little bit lighter with those darker gaps between the rocks. But on the whole, quite pleased. Manarola, contre jour in the sun. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch up with you on the next video. Bye-bye.